There's another beautiful line over this way. Maybe we'll get more lucky this time. That was toasty. Oh, okay. Yeah, that worked well. Hello people there, this is the Ruby Revolution. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to a special War Thunder video today for my 100 subscriber special. We're going to be looking at my most beloved favourite aircraft of all time, which is the de Havilland Mosquito. I absolutely love this plane. It's so gorgeous. I've always loved this plane from a very, very young age. When I was about seven years old, I saw a film on the television, which is called 633 Squadron. And in this film, they've got mosquitoes that follows a fictional squadron called 633 Squadron, which fly the mosquito, and it's about their training and the lead up to a mission attacking a fuel depot in Norway. It's got some amazing scenes in it of the Havilland Mosquito flying around, as well as some really questionable special effects as well. The end cinematic when the end of the film is really, really interesting. It's when you have a look at that compared to, say, the Star Wars in A New Hope with the Death Star run, there's a lot of similarities with that, and that they're both flying down basically a channel, attacking a objective at the end. It's really, very similar. There's actually a video on YouTube which somebody's edited the Star Wars over the top of it. It's very interesting to watch indeed. George Lucas definitely got an influence from that film. Anyway, looking at some of the history behind the de Havilland Mosquito, the origins of this aircraft can be traced to 1936, where de Havilland were looking at a new fast bomber for the Royal Air Force. They envisioned it being unarmed, very fast, and being able to carry a modest bomb load. Over time, there was many wild iterations of the Mosquito, being unarmed, being having defensive armaments as well as armaments, different crew members. The project was even abandoned at some points during the Battle of Britain because of requirements for different aircraft, such as the Spitfire and the Hawker Hurricane, taking precedence over designing a brand new aircraft. By 1941, the project was picked up again, and the first prototype for this aircraft flew in November of that year. By 1942, the Mosquito was introduced into service with a fighter and a photo reconnaissance role. It's extremely fast fighter. It was quicker than the Spitfire at the time, had a good ceiling, and it was able to basically outrun and outturn and outmaneuver the enemies to be able to get away from them doing its photo reconnaissance and a fighter role. Over time, there's many iterations of the Mosquito introduced. Most people think of what is the best fighter or best aircraft from the Second World War. Most people say the Spitfire or the P-51 or the BF-109. But for me, it is the de Havilland Mosquito, purely because of how many different roles this aircraft could perform. It could perform a fighter role, fighter bomber, night fighter, naval attack aircraft, anti-submarine warfare it could perform, strike aircraft. It was a pathfinder during nighttime, and there's just so many different roles. This aircraft is just phenomenal for how many different types of roles it could perform, and perform it really well as well. It's just an absolutely incredible aircraft. Nearly 8,000 of these were introduced throughout the war. It really is just an absolute gorgeous, gorgeous aircraft. Many people commented, especially the Germans as well, on how good this aircraft was. I think it was Hermann Göring said that they basically commented saying that they were... He was very jealous of how this aircraft is, and the Germans could not produce an aircraft as good as the Mosquito was. After the war ended, this aircraft stayed in service for quite a long time, to like the 1950s, really, in frontline service. Finally been retired in the 1960s. For many years, there wasn't that many really left flying. The last one before some new ones were basically reconstructed from molds, etc., crashed in the 1990s. Real shame. I've never had the privilege of seeing this aircraft flying, but there is now three aircraft of these flying in the world, which are in like New Zealand and Canada, I think. So there is some flying examples of this absolutely amazing aircraft still out there, which is absolutely incredible. I love the Mosquito. It's so good. Anyway, how does the Mosquito perform at War Thunder? It's a bit of a mixed bag, I'm going to be honest. There was a time when the Mosquito was a really, really good aircraft. It could outturn a BF-109 with combat flaps, if you would believe. It also had different battle rating. It was like at 5.7 at one point, which is absolutely crazy. Nowadays, it's a 3.7 battle rating. The variants we have in game, there's two variants. We have the Mark 6, which is the fighter bomber variant, as well as the Mark 18, which is the one armed with a 57mm Molins cannon, which was designed for anti-submarine warfare. It's a very interesting version of the aircraft. It does perform really well in War Thunder. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to be taking out the Mark 6 in an air realistic battle, showing what it can do. And then I'm going to be taking this lineup here with the Mark 18 with the Cromwells as well into a couple of games to really put that 57mm to work. I absolutely love the Mosquito. This is going to be so much fun today. Let's get going. Okay, welcome to Battle for the Rhine in the Mark 6 Mozzie. This is armed with 20mm cannons for these, as well as four 7.7s. All mounted to do the nose, which is really nice when makes the grouping really nice and tight, and not really have to worry much about convergence. I've also got rockets on this one. I'm going to try and shoot down some enemy bombers if I can. You can use it for ground attack, and they can carry 500-pound bombs as well. But it's pretty lightly armoured, really, for the ground attack role. The 57mm one is much better suited, really, compared to the fighter bomber variant. I'm going to be climbing up, getting some altitude to try and take on some of those pesky bombers, I think. The Mosquito is definitely a fast twin-engine fighter, but it's not as quick as some of the other aircraft at this tier, which is a bit of a shame, really. It would be nice if the Mozzie was quicker than one, but the game is balanced, I guess, so we just have to roll with it. Oh, here we go. I'm going to try hitting the rockets if I can. I knew it was definitely worth taking those. That's one way to tuck those down. There's a P-1008B. Oh, he's been shot down. That was unconventional, but definitely worth it. Looks like an SM-91 maybe ahead. Let's keep climbing up for now. Oh, there's a Dornier down low. Oh, it's a BF-110. Okay, two BF-110s. Now, I should have definitely the advantage over these in terms of the speed. We're gonna dive on this one. And then we're going to pull out, because the BF-109s are coming in. Oh, no. I screwed up the attack there. We're gonna bail out of here. The BF-109s are coming in. Let's go, Mossie. Put that speed to use. We're nearly at 700 kilometers an hour here. I might come back in now. The F110's definitely the best target for us to go for. Let's see if I can get on his tail. Oh, this BF-109's in the stall though. Come on, come on. Come on, Mozzie. No, he's gaining the speed. See, 2F5's down. Oh, come on. Make him turn, Yak. This guy's got lots of problems. Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Wow, what an absolute slaughter of a game. Oh, CO202 down low, let's go. Oh, he's been set on fire. That's the guy with 2 kills. Gotta feel sorry for that guy. Ah, there's the last guy. He's so far off. It's gonna take forever to climb up to him, okay.
6.5 hours later.
well, it's not conventional, but I'll definitely take it. Oh my god, look how close we are to losing as well. Oh, what a game. I really didn't expect that last game to go like that. I guess the rockets are the most effective weapons on the Mozzie. What a definitely amazing multi-role fighter. Definitely unconventional fighter this is. Anyway, we are on a Battle of the Rhine for this one versus Germany and Italy. We're going to try and take on those pesky bombers once again with the Mozzie. I can already see one in the distance. That's got to be a BV-238. We'll climb up. See if we can get to his altitude. See if we can get another rocket kill again. Oh, he's turning. Got his attention now, though. Come on, Mossy. No. Ah, she didn't want to nose up for me at all. Oh, look at how much spam. It's disgusting how much firepower the BV-238s have. Absolutely disgusting. If it's stupid and it worked, guys, it's not stupid. Oh, that was a... This is the best BV238 kit I know in the game. This is very good. Let's not kid ourselves here. Is there another one up here? We've got some enemies up high. Let's dive away. Okay, we've got a BF-109. Oh, we've got a few BF-109s down low. Right, let's just go in. Our team's very much losing this game. Oh, there's a HE-219. We might take him on them first. He's definitely the easier target for us. Again, there. Nah, we're gonna stay. Let's not get ourselves. Oh, there's another BF-109 coming in. Where are you going? She's not responding at the moment very well. Oh, he's got him. Oh, I've got a hit, nothing more. Oh my god. Why, War Thunder? Why do you do this all the time? Well, I think we've fulfilled our duty on the Mosquito today. Definitely unconventional, but definitely fun though. So, it's definitely interesting. It's just a shame that I cannot fly to save my life. I always kill myself in a realistic battle. It's what Rubles does best. Anyway, we're on the Cromwell 1 now. On Ash River. I really do love this tank. I use this for my channel artwork. It has a really nice gun, it's got really good speed, really mobile tank. The only thing it doesn't do very well, it's just got a horrendously bad reverse speed, which is only -3 kilometers an hour. So the only way to play this thing is just to drive forward at all times. Never reversing this thing at all. Oh, there's an enemy coming in. Good crit. Come on. It's just the follow-up shots on the KV-2 was a pain. Come on, Cromwell. There we go. We're capping the point. Oh, bounced a shot. I'm gonna get into some better cover here. Oh, no wonder I couldn't get up there. So. Did we just bounce the KV-2 shell? I think we did. Okay, we're gonna assist on that guy. The gun depression on this one is also really, really good. Oh, there's enemies coming up to the left. Enemies there. I'm not sure what is. Okay. We can get this guy. I need one crew member. Okay, hit out the engine. We should have him now. There we go, set a fire. Uh-oh. That worked. Oh, I'm gonna hit the machine gun port. Let's pull back into a cover. Another kill. What's this over here? ASU. Oh, this gun's good. No, don't kill me. Don't do it. Okay. Let's smoke up. Might be able to get back into cover here. Yeah, okay. Let's sit here, repair. Let's keep on popping smoke. We've got so much smoke on this thing, so we might as well use them. There we go. We're back up now. The smoke's about to clear. Everything's good. KB-1's just died. Where's the Panzer gone? I might try jumping to the Mozzie now. Oh, okay. We're definitely jumping into the Mozzie now. Okay, here we go. We're in the Mark 18 Mozzie now with the Molins gun, which is designed for anti-submarine warfare, but it has 110mm of penetration in warfare, and a pretty rapid firing as well, so it's really good at taking on tanks. You can get quite a few shots in one pass, which is always really nice. Looks like there's an enemy down here. If he's still alive. Yeah, he's definitely still alive. I'm sure there is. Jack Panzer 4 maybe? Oh yeah, he's dead. Oh, there's a guy here as well. What is that? No, no sauce. Pulling out. Oh, there's a lot of them behind there. Come back in. Oh, let's not crash. Good angle. Good crit. 57 minutes is really good on this. There's everyone's over there. We'll come back in for another pass. We've got to be careful with the cliffs, so we'll come in this way. There we go. I just have the 633 squadron theme tune just playing in my head continuously all the time while playing the Mosquito. There we go. Lining up. Set a fire. Oh, we should get him on the next pass. Still got loads of rounds left. 18 shells. We'll get him. He's only going to have like two crew members left. How is he still living? There we go. I do like to live dangerously in the Mosquito, that's for sure. I might find the 7.7s at the Decker Max as well. Oh, the Mosquito is so fun to play. The fox in, and then back down. Oh, the Decker Max is down. Loads of them coming in. I'll go for the Panzer. No real source there. Got one hit, but that's it. Oh no, I've got a plane. Oh, there's a plane on me. Leave me alone. No! Rubles doesn't want to die. But this guy's a terrible shot. An absolute terrible shot. And we're still flying somehow. Might be able to make it back to base. I think he's out of ammo. Why do you think he's out of ammo? Oh, we're going to come in for another pass. This game's nearly over. We need to try and get a kill. What is going on with this aircraft? Wow. Wow. What is going on? Anything? Oh, there's a guy here. Just about. No kills though, that's a shame. We will get our kill in the Mosquito, I will not give up until we do. We're on Stalingrad for this one, just waiting for the friendlies to catch up before we cap the A point, get some of those juicy capture points. Wait for the 244, then start capping. There we go. I really do love the Cromwell. It's basically like a British M18, apart from the reverse speed. Maybe it's got to capture anything yet. Okay. It's captured, let's go. I'll go to the left here. Good hit. Oh, why? We're gonna vanish here. If the Cromwell will work for me, come on. Come on, Cromwell. There we go. He's just behind here, it looks like, but we're gonna vanish. Very lucky not to die there. Oh, he's died, okay. Let's try and flank round. On this one. Did that even go through? I don't even know. Nice. Two good kills. Is anybody else over here? I'll die happily now. I think there is. Oh god, there's a puma just there. Hey puma, how you doing? You just stay just there. Just there. No, I don't want to die. That was firing at me. Oh, okay. Oh, great. There's quite a few enemy planes up. This is going to make things tricky and interesting. One looks like a bomber. In fact, they both look like bombers. Oh good, the ME410's crashed. Not sure what this is. Yeah, there's quite a few of them in B. They're gonna take on whatever the fuck this is. Oh, it's a Heinkel. I might just leave him. Oh no. Has he lost half his wing? No, he's still flying. Ooh. Well, we got an aircraft kill. Oh, there's another aircraft now. We'll come in for one pass, and then we're going to get out of here. Oh, he's dead. Okay. Right, we're booking out. That's definitely an ME-410. Oh, please be crashing. Oh, not quite. Okay, the ME-410's got some problems now. There's loads of enemy aircraft coming in. We're gonna come in for another pass here. Oh, it's a duck. Get the nose sauce. Oh, the duck's down. Oh, my brother's dead. Never mind. Oh, he's coming for me, isn't he? Yeah. God, he's breaking off. Oh, thank God the Spitfire's coming in for him. Oh, he's got him, I think. Oh, thank God. Okay, we can come in for another attack. 13 shells left. Not had the best run yet on enemy tanks. Oh, well, that definitely worked. That definitely worked. Let's get out of here. Stay low, stay fast. Okay, enemy there. We'll come in for him for the next pass. There's no aircraft up, which is really nice. Oh, there is an anti-air, though. Yeah, there's the R3 spraying and praying. We'll come in from the rear, I think. Another aircraft. Right, we're gonna come back in. We're gonna try and get the R3 if we can. See him now. There he is. Oh, good crap. Oh no, my tail's been shot off. Oh, I've lost the elevators. Oh, it's going too good. And the plane's got me now. No, Rubles does not want to die. Come on, guys. Come on, you can get him. Oh. Where do these planes keep coming from? Honestly, there's another one up now. And that R3 is still ripping to shreds many people on our team. Yeah, he's just got the Spitfire as well. This is going to be challenging. Thank you. Looks like some twin bomber though, twin engine, sorry. Oh, there's two planes. No rest of the wicked. Oh, is that an SM-91? I think it is. We're gonna wait a minute. We've got a lot of friends up, so. Okay, the zone's a little bit hotly contested at the moment, so we're gonna wait until our friends get involved before coming back in. There are three still up as well. They're capping all the points. Well, this isn't good. Our teams got smashed. I guess we'll try and come in. We need to take out the R3, really. Oh, there's a few anti-aero. Oh, he's got him. Well done, Wellington. Well done. We need to take out this SM-91 if we can. So much anti-air fire coming in. I'm alright. Good crit on that guy, but might have to come back in for another pass on him. That guy's dying. Let's try again. This game is very hopelessly lost now, unfortunately. Oh shit! Oh, the plane got me. What the hell? Oh. This has been a lot of fun today, taking out my favourite aircraft as well as the Cromwell as well. I do absolutely adore the Mosquito. The Mark 18 with the Molins is a really good ground attack aircraft. It just has the speed over the other aircraft at this tier, such as the Duck, which means you can be in and you're out, you've done your damage before the enemy even realise you're attacking them, which is a real massive competitive edge when it comes to the ground attack. The Mark 6 in-game is really nothing special, to be honest. It's when it loads up, eventually it will. We'll get around to it. Yeah, it's really not something massively special in-game. It's pretty subpar, really. It used to be really good back in the day. It's like patched like 1.55, the Mosquito. Really, really, really did used to be pretty good against, say, the BF-109s. But over time, it's just the game has just moved on, and it's just now another aircraft which no one really plays that much. Which is a massive, massive shame. Anyway, I hope you've all enjoyed today's video looking at my favourite aircraft. Thank you so much, guys, for 100 subscribers for YouTube. Hopefully soon will be a massive one for when we get to 1,000. I'm sure it won't be that far away. Definitely picking up the pace now. It's absolutely amazing. Please like, comment, share, all that good stuff. And I'll catch you on the next one sometime soon. Bye!